Welcome to Hako Machines Limited training video for the Sweepmaster B900R and B980R. During this video, you will learn how to ensure the machine is ready for use and how to operate the machine, daily and weekly maintenance, and troubleshooting guides. Sweepmaster B900R and B980R. Working width from 70 centimeters to 120 centimeters. Efficiency up to 5,800 square meters per hour. Waste container volume 60 liters. To illustrate how to prepare the machine for work and operate the machine, this video will cover how to unplug the battery, an overview of the control panel, the importance of sweeping, and how to operate the machine. Before starting work, check on the charger that the battery is fully charged, then disconnect the battery from the charger. Connect the batteries. And close the battery cover. After turning the key, the battery discharge status will appear. The battery should be fully charged before starting work. Control panel overview for the Sweepmaster B900R. There's a key to turn on the machine, a filter shake system lever, a lever to lower and run the side brush, a lever to lower and run the main brush, a forward pedal, reverse pedal, a brake pedal, a pedal to open the sweeping lid of the large garbage area, a horn. The control panel of the Sweepmaster B980R differs from that of a B900R in the following ways. There's a key to turn on the machine, a lever to lower and run the side brush, a waste container lifting and lowering button, an optional working light, an optional warning light and signal, a filter shake system lever, the horn button, waste container lock button, and a lever to lower and run the main brush. The sweeping process is not an additional element of cleaning, but the basis of the cleaning process. Before floor cleaning or washing can start, it's necessary to remove debris, both large and small, from the surface. Regardless of the choice of the sweeping method, manual or machine, this operation is necessary before washing. Before you start cleaning, you should plan your route. Ideally, you should avoid narrow turns and driving over the same area of flooring. You should always try and keep a 10% overlap on your cleaning route. This will avoid leaving marks. To illustrate daily and weekly maintenance, this section of this video will cover how to remove and clean the filter, how to empty the waste container, how to clean the machine, how to charge the batteries, and how to change the brushes. Before cleaning the filter, use the filter shake system. Open the main cover. Remove the filter cover. Loosen the screws securing the filter shake system. Pivot and lock the clamping frame and remove the filter. Gently tap the filter a few times to shake off the dust. And then vacuum it thoroughly. Return the clean filter, securing it with the frame and tightening with the safety screws. cover the filter with the lid and close the main cover. The method of removing the filter on the Sweepmaster B980R is different from the B900R model. Open the main cover, open the latches and remove the filter cover. Loosen the screws that secure the filter shake system. Pivot and lock the clamping frame and remove the filter. The filter cleaning process itself is the same as in the Sweepmaster B900R. Return the clean filter, securing it with the frame and tightening with the safety screws. Cover the filter with the lid. Close the latches. And close the main cover. Remember, on all filters there is a mark indicating the correct up-down placement of the filter. The Sweepmaster B900R is equipped with two waste containers located at the back of the machine. Unlock the containers with the lever, pull it out of the holder, then empty it in a designated place. Emptying the waste container on the Sweepmaster B980R is automatic. Press and hold the waste container lock button. Press the waste container lifting and lowering button. Control the lifting height of the container and stop it by releasing both buttons at a height enabling safe disposal of waste in a designated place. Lift the lever on the left side of the seat to empty the container. Lower the container using the control buttons. Wash the machine and all its parts regularly and thoroughly. Keeping the machine cleaned and well maintained will ensure a long life and the best possible levels of cleaning for your machine. After finishing sweeping, always connect the batteries of the machine to the charger to top up the battery level. The start of battery charging will be indicated on the charger. The main brushes and side brushes of the machine wear out during operation and should be replaced periodically. The side brush is mounted with one screw and its replacement requires the use of basic tools. The main brush is inside the machine. In both cases, the brushes should be replaced by the operator in accordance with the provided operating instructions with particular care. The next section in this video shows how to carry out troubleshooting the most frequent problems, including the machine does not turn on, the machine stops working, the machine is not sweeping floors thoroughly. If the machine does not turn on when the key is turned, check that the battery is charged. When you leave the seat while driving, the machine will stop working. Sit back, turn the machine on with the key, and start working again. If the sweeping effects are unsatisfactory, check the brushes for wear or adjust them. Adjust the side brush pressure with the knob located under the machine next to the brush. The adjustment of the sweeping brush's main sweep width is located under the machine's main cover. Use the knob to increase or decrease the sweeping path. Detailed information on brush adjustment can be found in the user manual. Following these recommendations, will ensure trouble-free and effective work with Sweepmaster B900R and B980R machines. All information not included in this training video can be found in the user manual.